Good morning, everyone. This is Bhaskar, Assistant Professor of English in St. Martin's Engineering College. So today's my topic for discussion is group discussion. It is very useful for everyone's life. As a student, you must be aware of group discussion. Since after completion of your studies, higher studies, or any, if you want to get any job, whether it is government or private, so you should be aware of this group discussion. What is the need of having group discussions? What is the importance of group discussion? Why should we conduct group discussions for selecting process? So all these things we will learn today. So if you ignore these skills, you will not get good job in your private sector. Of course, you will get good jobs in government sector. But if you want to settle in private sector, you should be aware of what is group discussion and all. So we will see what is group discussion, how it is going on. So what is the conducting of importance of group discussion, we will see. So group discussion, what is, first of all we must know what is group discussion. So what is the definition of group discussion? A group discussion is a combination of two words, group plus discussion. So already it is a group and discussion. Group, not solo, not solo, not single. Group of people, whether it is 5 people or 10 students or 7 or any group, not any one or two. If it is 2 people, it is not group. More than 3 or 4, it is a group, called group. Group plus discussion. So group discussion is a combination of two words, that is group and discussion. So group, without a group, there is no discussion. So that is the reason. Let us discuss in detail. So what is it? We will see one by one. So what is it? We will see. Yeah, group. First of all, we will see in topic itself, it is a group and discussion, group discussion. We will see what is group first, then we will go to the discussion. A group means many people are working together to achieve some targets. So any kind of people, whether they are students, whether they are employees, whether they are non-educated or any other group of people working for any targets, for getting good targets, achieving for better benefits. So group means many people are working together to achieve some targets. The performance of a group depends on the collaborative work of the individuals. So this is very important point. Second point is very important. Collaborative work of individual. So everybody should work as a team. For example, if I am working here, if I don't support to my colleagues, it is not group work, it is not collaborative work. It is selfish work, just I am doing myself, my benefit. If you work all together, it will give benefit to the or institute or college or any other things. So it should be collaborative work or cooperative work. Teamwork should be there wherever we go. That's more important. The team of 3 or more than 3 people is considered as a group. See, if it is 2 students or 2 people, it is not a group. More than 3, 2, 4, 5. So there is number, specific numbers. So we will have it. But more than 3 is called a group. So we will see one by one. Yeah, we have seen group. Now discussion. What is the meaning of discussion? What is the need of conducting discussion within the group? So let us have. Discussion means exchanging ideas between 2 or more than 2 people, which is generally a face-to-face interaction. Yeah, group discussion should not be virtual conference like. It should be meeting together. Physically we are facing each other. We are meeting each other and discussing and sharing our ideas to improve our organization, to improve our knowledge, to improve our subject. So that is the reason we should improve our knowledge by discussing good ideas, thought-provoking ideas. It is a process of talking between people to reach a specific decision. It is also defined as a conversation about a specific topic. So in group discussion, one facilitator will give one specific topic. Particular topic you have to discuss on what are the pros, what are the cons, how to use it, what is the final conclusion. So you have to discuss among yourself and give conclusion. So what is it use, what is it need? That is the reason it is main intention. The result or end can be a particular decision. Enhance knowledge, actions or argument, doubt, pleading and disagreement. So after discussion, after ending, this will come out. We will share our knowledge. What happened, sir? It will share our knowledge and we will exchange our ideas and we will argue with each other. So in this way we have to improve our group discussion. So it is more important. So this is the pattern of sitting in the group discussion. He is the initiator. he is a just like mentor, teacher. So he will guide how to teach, what to discuss, how to discuss. He will facilitate the students so that it will help us to improve their skills. So these are the students, just like 6 students. So he is a mentor. So why group discussion is important? So what is the importance of conducting group discussions in any organization? What is the need? Over the last years, GDE is used to test the skills of the candidates, to test any candidate, any student, where to test their particular skills. So that is the reason they conducted group discussions in various fields. So it is used as a quick method to shortlist a few candidates from the massive strength. So why? Because these days they are having many competitors in the world. To get any job, number of applicants are coming out. So to short it, to make it short, we are conducting group discussion. In group discussion, they will test their knowledge, their subject knowledge, their language skills, their confidence level, their teamwork. They will test all these skills to select the good candidate. So the written text takes the knowledge and aptitude. So they will give a written text and they will test their personal attitude, their body language, their behavior. They will see all these skills. Next conclusion. Organizations check the social skills, technical and communication skills so that the candidate can work effectively without any obstacles in between his or her skills. So any organization, they look for good candidates, good in the sense not physically good. It should be mingled with all participants with happily, without any problem to society, without any problem to the organization. In this way, they have to work, communicate effectively, and we work with teamwork, and candidates should work with promptly without having any side problems. And they will also check their personality skills like communication skills, teamwork, confidence, problem solving skills, social skills, behavior, and leadership skills, abilities. They can check all these skills to check, to select the candidate for giving employment. Who are the panelists? So who will conduct this group discussion? There are the people who judge the group discussion. Evaluation parameters are different from company to company. There is no proper formal process. My company is different from others' company, so they have their own rules and all. But somebody have their own rules. Based on the process, they will conduct group discussion. Yeah, group discussion process. The participants can range from 7 to 12. Already we have discussed. So in any group discussion, the average participants are from 7 to 12 in a group. It should be moderate. It should be very flexible for each one of us. Right? If the strength is low, the number of participants can be range from 5 to 7 also. It can be less. If the strength is very less, we can have numbers from 5 to 7 and 5 to 8. But minimum is more than 5. So we may think, what is the duration of a GD? The average duration of GD is 15 minutes. But it may vary from depending on the number of candidates in a group. So there is no specific time. We should complete within 10 minutes. There is no specific time complete within 15 minutes. But based on the topic, based on the circumstances, based on the candidates' interaction, we may exceed the time. But there is no specific time. We should complete only within 10 minutes. There is no specific time. Sometimes the panelists or judges can extend the time for discussion for 15 or 20 minutes. It depends on the topic, depends on the students. Yeah, the process should be like this. The mentor give a topic and topic announcement. He will assign a topic and then the preparation time. The mentor will give preparation time for 3 to 4 minutes, not more than that. 3 to 4 minutes. So based on the topics, the students have to take down the important points and they have to discuss on what the topic is given. And they start the discussion are followed by other participants. Right, this is also important. So one candidate should be leader. That is initiator. One who starts the discussion is initiator. So you should have some awareness of topic thoroughly. Then only he is able to start the topic. And summarize should be there. And at the same time, it should be summarized and judgment of individual performance. And finally, what mentor will do? He will do the performance of individually, so that the candidate is suitable or not, he will judge by doing, participating in group discussion. What is the importance of group discussion? Why should we conduct group discussion? Group discussions are an essential part of testing candidates in organizations, recruitment process. Yeah, these are important. Organizations and recruitment process. Increases of confidence. So for conducting this, they will increase their confidence level. The GD allows the participants to speak in public, which increases their confidence to speak without any hesitation. For example, some students are introvert. They cannot speak in front of others. They have good knowledge over a subject. But whereas coming to the public, they may not share their ideas. But writing part, they are okay. But coming to the public speaking, they are not able to speak. So to overcome those problems, this group discussion is conducting effectively. See, important is safe definition. Focus on deep thinking. So if you are participating in group discussion, your thinking level will be increased. You will think of what topics, what points you have to write down, on what points you have to speak out in front of your peers. So that is, you will think deep and your communication skills will improve. If you speak publicly, if something goes wrong first time, second time you will not repeat same problem, same thing. So you will improve your communication. So because of group discussion, you will improve your communication skills and you will think more effectively. And remove hesitation of public speaking. And you will not, first of all, you may not speak public, but after following all this, you may improve your speaking in front of your peers, your friends, your audience. So remove hesitation of speaking. You will speak whenever topic is given, wherever the topic is given, since you may have the confidence levels. Teamwork, you will improve your teamwork. You may think that I may work with anyone, whether they are good or bad. I can mingle with anyone without any problem. Why? Because I can manage myself, I can control myself if any problem is there. He has that knowledge. Yeah, and moreover, behavior is also more important in group discussion. Behavior, our attitude tells our character. Attitude is more important. And listening skills, listening is also more important. First of all, we have to listen what others are telling. If you don't listen, just blindly talking, it is nonsense. So you have to listen others speaking, then we have to speak according to their response. Rules for group discussion, what are the rules? Prepare well for the topic. The topic is given, so you have to prepare thoroughly. Then only you are able to speak good points. And be confident about your content. So what you have written down, you should be very confident. You may think that somebody may think something wrong, somebody may think something bad. You should not think. Just confident enough what you have written, the content. Content means the topic what is given, the points what you have written on particular page. Yeah, participants introduction. So you have to introduce yourself, just like my name is so and so, I am from so and so. So you have to introduce yourself and you have to say the next point is you have to introduce the topic. First introduce yourself and say the topic what you are giving your side. Points, important points, whether it is negative or positive, you have to give without any problem, without any hesitation. And your body language plays vital role. Body language is more important. By speaking to your friends or your team members, body language should be very flexible, very comfort. You should not be very anger, you should not be very jealous or very nervous. You should be very flexible to everyone. And you can improve your leadership skills by participating in any group discussion. You will improve your leadership skills. Leader is leading from the front. You should be lead all the team from the front. And avoid false starts or commitments. We should avoid, this should not be done in any group discussion. We should avoid false statements or starts. You should not say just rumors. Somebody said like this, so I will fall, I will believe that thing. And you should not put on it. So you should depend on what you are telling. You should not depend on somebody's statement. Okay, and do not fight. For example, you are telling your own point. Somebody may not accept. But you should not fight orally, not physical fighting here. Fighting means not physically, oral fighting. Argument, it should not be argumentative. Debate is argument, where it is a discussion. Group discussion, it is not debate. So you should not fight each other orally. Yeah, by conducting group discussion, what every candidate has, what they will improve by conducting group discussion, individual skills, what they can improve. They can improve communication skills. Yeah, these are more important. For many of us, they have subject knowledge, but whereas coming to the speaking skills, they are lack of communication. Why? Because they are not aware of English language. If you go anywhere, you should have communicated with them English only. If you go for any interview, they will not ask our mother tongue or any other tongue. They will ask in English only. You should be thorough with English, with good communication skills. You should improve your communication skills. And content, this is also important. Content with subject, what you are asking, discussion. Content is more important. But this content should be expressed through communication, English. So English is more important. And analytical skills, analysis. You have to analyze whether it is right or wrong. You should think of yourself. And you have to think inner side, whether it is going right way or wrong way. How way I am going, you have to think yourself. And creativity, you should be there. Create something different. If you are following everybody's route, there is no difference. All are same. If you think differently and you are giving some important points, that means everybody will follow you. You should not follow others. They will follow your steps. So creativity should be there. And finally, what will happen? Decision making. You will think of yourself and you will decide whether it is right or wrong. No need to depend on somebody's attention. You will think yourself, is it right or wrong? That is also important. And reasoning skills, you will also improve reasoning skills. Whether it is right or wrong, you will improve. So all these are individual skills. We can improve ourselves by having group discussions. So these are the major parts. So these are the major parts we can have it. So there are some more things. So for today's topic, these are main points I have covered. So thank you, Varanda. Thank you very much.